Okay. Yeah, after hearing information from the project itself, my talk is more from the user perspective. I'm using PostGIS since a long time in projects, and I discovered foreign data wrapper some time ago and thought that would be a great thing to talk about. And yeah, maybe I have to tell you, I have no maps, no animations in the talk, so you will see some SQL, and I wanted to extend the fun part of it, but maybe foreign data wrapper are fun themselves, so you will see. So the goal about foreign data wrapper is to get access to other sources via foreign data wrapper. When I do courses, people complain and they ask, how can I get that from one database to another? And I would like to join them and combine the data. And yeah, we will see how this will work. So I came from Germany, I'm from work group. Someone thought I'm Romanian because I had the local team t-shirt, but I'm not, I'm from Bonn and I work at work group. And we do a lot of WebGS application where most of our customers use PostgreSQL as database. Yes, and if you want to try out foreign data wrapper, I will be at the code sprint, a community sprint tomorrow, so we could have a look, a closer look. The presentation is made up that you can easily do the steps on your own. You can use OSU Live. There's all the data that I use in the presentation, and foreign data wrapper are there as well. So my slides, or you can use pgAdmin 4 or 3 to do it. You can use it on the command line, but here's only the steps how you can install pgAdmin 4. So why shall we use foreign data wrapper? Why is it fun to work with them? Because we have already DB-Link, maybe, to link from one database to another. So who knows DB-Link here in the audience? Some of you, okay. So this is this functionality is around quite a long time, I think. It's an extension nowadays, and it enables you to go to another database from your database, which you are in. In this case, I go from Natural Earth to OpenStreetMap OSM Local. I take the points that we ship with OSU Live and look for cafes. They are Bucharest data, so I want to find out how many cafes, because I like coffee, are in Bucharest. And this is how I can do it with DB-Link. So I have to define the database I want to connect, and it was a bit of work. I always have to define which data type the columns are that I want to connect, and then I can go on. Okay. So I found out that there are 70 cafes. No, that's not, can't be. But there are some coffees in Bucharest. So now we have an extended way, because with DB-Link I only can connect to other PostgreSQL databases, but I want to connect to other data sources in general. And this was implemented in an SQL standard. It's the SQL MED standard. And this is where it is defined how this connection will work. Online, it said this standard is from 2008. In the foreign data documentation, it says 2001, so I'm not sure about it. I will find out. And when you implement this standard, you can connect to two different external data sources. Who implemented this standard? It says that MariaDB implemented it, but they did it not following the standard so strict, so they implemented a connect functionality, and DB2, they connected it, and PostgreSQL, it was invented in 2011 to PostgreSQL with read-only support in version 9.1, and now in 2013 we have write support since version 9.3. There's a long wiki page, a nice wiki page where you can get an overview on foreign data wrapper and which external projects support these functionality. So as you can see here, there are different projects listed here, like Oracle, ODBC, you can connect, you have SQLite, you have Twitter, you have all sort of connections you can build up. And for every external data, it may be a different way of installing it, so you have to check the installation and see how you can get it running. So you have one foreign data wrapper. So we saw many sources are supported. It was not the whole list. On the wiki page, there are some more projects. And for example, you can connect to other databases, to other PostgreSQL databases. You can connect to flat files. And maybe the most interesting thing for us is you can connect to other geospatial data sources. Because in a minute, I will talk about the OGR foreign data wrapper. And there's a project that helps you to, for example, connect to Twitter. There are different ways of installation. I mentioned this already. And now we will have a look how, as compared with a DB-Link version, you can do a connection from one to another database with foreign data wrapper. So the process is always the same. You load an extension which enables you to connect to a foreign data source. Then you create a foreign server. You create a foreign user because the user you use in PostgreSQL is not the same that you may use to connect to an Oracle database or to some other source. It's not always the case that you need this foreign user, but with some of the connections. And then you can start and connect to tables and build up foreign tables and have fun and easily work on external data as if the data would be in your database. So let's see the steps, how they look like. Create extension, Postgres FDV, FDW. So this is a foreign data wrapper that is already shipped on installation from PostgreSQL, so you can use it out of the box without installing it. And here you see how you can create a you can't see it so properly, but I hope you can imagine. It says create server, and you give a name to the server, and then you say which foreign data wrapper you want to use. In my case, it's PostgreSQL foreign data wrapper. And then you, as well, have to define the options, how you can go to this external data source and build up the connection. For the user mapping, it looks like this. You create a user, you create user mapping for user, and then define which server this user should be, for which server, and you define the options. So you say, okay, take this username and this password, and then I go to the other database and you get authenticated. The next step, you want to create a foreign table. So the first line is only that I want to separate maybe the data from my data, so I created a schema with a different name. And then there's a nice functionality. You can import foreign schema from the other database. And in my case, I say, okay, import foreign schema public. So all of the tables that are in the other database in public schema will be imported, or only the syntax of the tables is imported to my database. When I do this, I could, and I'm not interested in all the tables, I could limit the import and say, oh, I only want this and that table, or I could say, okay, some tables I don't want to import, and like this, you can only get the tables that you are interested in. And then the data, you have access to this data source from your database and can easily run a query where you combine both data sources. And here we can see 147 fees in Bucharest. So maybe at the beginning you won't, if you use pgAdmin 3 still, you may not find the foreign data wrapper sections because they are not activated by default. You have to go to your options in pgAdmin and activate some of the checkboxes, so foreign server, foreign data wrapper, user mapping, and foreign table. And then you will see them in the tree. So you see foreign tables here in the middle. You see a bit more above the foreign server and the different server and also the user mapping. So here's a small example where you can connect to plain files. So on OSU Live, we have a password file for the programs where you need a password. So I would like to have access to this file from my database. So there's an extension, it's called File Foreign Data Wrapper. And you see this, the password file is on my desktop. And now I want to create a server. And it's a foreign data wrapper. Oh, maybe there's something. To access to this file, foreign data wrapper. And I don't need a user mapping. And first I had to create the extension file foreign data wrapper. Maybe I missed that in the slides. And then I can import this table as we saw it in the example before and have easily access to the data from this file. Okay, and I talked about proprietary software already, Oracle I was talking about, so or MS SQL or other databases you can connect. For example, Oracle, I have an example here, you can create extension Oracle Foreign Data Wrapper, and it's if you have the concept, it's always very similar. So for every connection, a foreign data wrapper, maybe you have, the definition is maybe a bit different. So in this case, we define in options section the DB server to build up the connection. And we have to create the user mapping. And then we can create our foreign tables. So like this as well, you can combine tables as if they are in your database. When you connect to the tables on the remote database, the where clause is pushed down to the database, so not all the data is going to be loaded. The push down is already done for the required columns, and you have explained support. But now the fun part starts. We want to get access to geodata, and there's a foreign data wrapper that was implemented by Paul Ramsey. It's a OGR foreign data wrapper. And it, as we all love and know OGR Google, it supports a lot of vector formats. And you can access the data from your database. So like GeoPackage, WMS, OpenStreetMap data, SV Shapefile, KMN, and all sorts of data, even WFS3, you can connect to these formats. You can download and compile OGR foreign data wrapper on yourself, or if you use OSGeo Live 13, version 13, it's already shipped with OSGeo Live, and you can start from at once. And there are packages available, so you can could install it on your system as well. It's a long list. If you want to have a look at all the formats, I only have the top of the list. So if you want to know about which formats are supported, you can go to OGR Foreign Data Wrapper Info with -F, and it will give you a list of all the supported formats. And you also see whether they are only readable or read-write access does exist. And maybe you have the sticker as well. Let's have a look at S3 shapefile as long as it's still quite in use. So there's it's very easy to get connection to shapefiles. So we have this natural earth data on OSU Live. With this command, you can ask OGR for data wrapper info to list all the data, all the shape, the layers, we say, that is correlated to the shapefiles that are in this directory. And then I can define which of these layers I would like to import. So I, or whether I want to import them all, like this, I can import all the layer. And then I can create this. First I can create a connection to this directory, and then I can create a foreign table, and at the bottom you see in the options section which layer I would like to import in this, connect in with this table statement. And then I can work with this table as is it as with the shapefile as directly from my database. If I have encoding problems, there's a solution as well. I could add option parameter shape encoding Latin 1, for example, and then the encoding will be fine. You have the possibility to connect to OpenStreetMap data. So with the same concept with minus S, you can list all the layers, and then you can decide which of the layers you would like to connect. So you create a foreign server. The server gets a name already, and here you see data source. It's the OpenStreetMap file. Format, you always define the format of the data that you would like to connect, and then create your foreign table. The nice thing is that with this command, OGR foreign data wrapper info will write you already the SQL on the command line. So you can easily copy this definition, go to your database, and then run, maybe modify it a bit, and then run the SQLs there. Okay, so you also have access to explain analyze. I said it before in case of Oracle. And here you can see it's a small SQL where I connect to all the points where highway, I want to do, no, in the column highway, which are traffic signals. So when I run, there are 600 of them. And when I run it, you can see how, how the database gets the data, and here you see the foreign scan in the middle. Okay. Okay, this I skip. It was an example for NTF data, how you can connect to an NTF data. Then we have a very nice feature, you can connect to WFS. It's supported, it's read-only. Here in the first line, you see how you would delete a foreign server. So there are some connections to the user, to the table, so you have to use Cascade to delete it. And let's see what happens when you connect to a WFS. So in this case, for WFS, you have to define the data source. Then the format is WFS. And a nice thing, maybe your data remote data source does not answer, so you would like to know what happens, why it doesn't answer. And there's this config option, TPL debug, that you can set to on, and like this, you can get in the debug mode the information, maybe there's still an error with the request or with the version, and like this, it will be listed in the debug mode. Okay, so you can see here, you can set show client main messages, and set it to debug 2, and like this you will get the debug messages. And then you can, in the select, you can see, you can communicate with the WFS. And that's it. That's a short introduction into OGR WFS and WFS in gen. Foreign data wrapper in general. I hope you like it, and maybe one of you would like to try the feature, and if you have questions, come around and we can talk. I think we don't have a microphone for questions, so I'm not sure. Maybe if there's a question, I can repeat it. Pardon? I think so, yes. But I'm not sure. I didn't try all of them, and maybe I'm not so connected to every format. But if you have a look at the list, we will can find out. I said before, the question was, does WFS... No. In general, provides transactions. I'm not sure. Maybe you know.
Hi.
So I happen to know the interface itself provides the way to do transactions, but if the underlying data source doesn't have a way to implement transactions, it just skips them. Any other questions?
Sometimes it's a little bit of a pain if the schema of the source changes, so you have to drop and create the FTW connection. Or is there a better way, like refresh?
I think you would have to recreate it, but maybe Darafi knows something more. But yeah, so there's not a permanent connection to the source, I think, on the remote server. So when you try to connect it, it's built up. So if you change the schema in your remote database, maybe it will get an error, but I didn't try it.
So since the invention of import foreign schema, it's much easier because now you can just import a new one. You can just wipe it and re-import it, and that's two lines of code.
But you have to drop it first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Any other questions? Yeah.
Is there any magic user mapping type to channel the Active Directory login on a Windows client through to making a connection to a MS SQL server? Do you know that?
What was the last part? Sorry, to connect to an.
I was visiting a client, and they were talking about using the FTW to connect to their local MS SQL server, mm-hmm. which is uses their logged in Active Directory stuff. I'm not a Windows person, so I'm not really into it. But as far as I could see, you needed to authenticate the Postgres server instead of the local client using it. So. It was mm-hmm. if there was a way to channel the authentication through the FTW user mapping.
I don't know about that. Maybe.
Yes, there is a way. You can create multiple users, and there are scripts out there to import LDAP for sure to into the Postgres. Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Do you know of any practical use cases to this? Like, I've been using them, and I cannot say I've seen any proper real use, to be honest. Like, you've seen the schema changes that can bite you and stuff like that. So, yeah. As a developer, I would usually use APIs to, let's say, put data together with the microservices.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they're not a silver bullet, but they say you should use APIs as well in there. So why would you even have a foreign data wrapper to files or?
Yeah, I have a nice use case. I have a customer. They have a GeoPortal, and they have lots of search modules, but they have data from a big region, and they have the parcels and the house numbers, and they don't want to update them regularly, but want to access them via WFS. And we thought about, okay, let's connect the WFS, but the search module that we have doesn't support WFS. So in that case, we created a foreign data wrapper, and now we talk to this table that we created, and that will go to the WMS and gives back the address or the parcel number, a parcel. So like that, it was a very good use case for us and stopped us from updating the data and importing them to the database regularly. It was a really good solution for them.
Any other questions? For another, I'll take a second, just for another use case, if you've got a bunch of microservices, and once you want to implement analytics on top of that, and you didn't quite design it right, a quick way is to connect all the databases of all the data services of your microservices into one single database on Postgres. Mm-hmm. And after that, you got a powerful stuff to join them. Other questions? So thank you very much, Astrid. Cool.